Hey guys, welcome back to Red Dead Redemption. Last time we got a spiffy new gun. We figured out how to,
Of course I can. Said I would.
There's a foreman. His name is Danbury. There's the files in the office above the refinery room. That window with the blind drawn up.
I see.
If the files are as incriminating as we believe, Mr. Cornwall's men will destroy them if they know you're coming.
There's only one of me, son. I don't intend for them to know I'm coming. What will the files say?
There'll be a report from Leyland Oil Development Company.
You got the money?
Yes.
Any ideas how I sneak into this place?
You could crawl under the fence or hide in a wagon. They keep rolling in.
I'll go take a look.
If there's a problem, call for me.
I thought the whole point was that this had nothing to do with you.
Ideally.
If you are quick, you could climb into the back.
That wagon. Alright, let me just grab my bow. That wagon. Sneaking.
That you, Al? Hey, Tom? Picking up? Yep. Supposed to meet the early train to Saint Denis. Okay. Better get a move on then.
Must be Danbury.
Who?
What? Quieten yourself, friend. This won't take long. Danbury.
Yes?
I need some papers, my friend. Nothing important. A file. I'm from head office.
You're not from head office?
Does that seem important right now?
No.
Need a file by the Leyland Oil Development Company. The one about the oil near Wapiti?
I...
Danbury, Think, man. A mind is a terrible thing to lose. Especially over such a nice floor as this.
It's here! It's here!
Motion for this. No, Danbury.
Danbury, you okay?
Tell the guard you're fine.
Yes, it's just I'm working. All's fine.
Now stay quiet. Our head office will send me back to get you. Easy now, fellas.
Now, we won't tell you again. You're dead!
Better than I am.
That explosion came just in
time. I was happy to watch some of that oil burn. So you met Mr. Danbury?
Yes, don't worry. He was very obliging. I thought you wasn't getting involved.
Thought you were gonna enter and leave silently.
Thank you. Save my life.
Thank you. I hope. Well, I don't know what I hope. But who knows? Maybe these will be of some use. Here's your money.
Thank you.
Where do we need to go next? I'm gonna Harley hunt some deer real fast. See if I can get like a three. What I'm gonna do.
Yep.
Do some hunting. Study them.
Move it! Move it! On your knees!
Cancers! We will not take up a moment.
You better forget about this.
It's your train, fellas.
Give over your money and your valuables to my. Kim Padre here.
Well, you look familiar. Consider yourself warned.
Get away my damn deal. They want like shooting in the air, like bam, bam, bam. Mighty $2. get the deal. Drops. It's apparently two shots from a revolver.
Come on,
waste of his words. Really bad at hunting in this game.
Look out!
Honestly, you get most of the hours from just riding your horse from place to place. The horse stamina is probably supposed to be like all the way around and barely getting consumed. Fine. He did nothing wrong. Well, it's awful. Okay. Why did it take so long for them to notice? Also, why did it move as I was going to shoot? That was so dumb. I'm not gonna continue to just run around. I know for a fact I did not run this far away from my horse. I still got a perfect weapon. Which I will pick. At least I'm also heading closer to Dutch. Perfect weapon, pelt, and perfect weapon. I'm just leaking quests, I'm getting more money. Get the... I think this is the bank robbery. That's what we're doing next.
Out of the damn way!
Wake up! Go on, back to what I paid you for.
Hey there, buddy.
Hello again.
See my...
Run up a tab now, have we?
Sir, good morning.
Oh, we have a confirmed date. May 1899.
Did you hear about that gunfight out in the cornfield by Braithwaite Manor? Probably blame that on the Greys, too.
Mm-hmm.
We're leaving, we're leaving, we're leaving, we're leaving. I do kind of want to make a save where I have, like, essentially negative. Negative. What the hell?
Just get out of here.
No.
Stop!
No.
Are you dead? You're back here.
I beg you, stay away from me!
All right, we'll sort this out.
Got a real situation here. Guns at the ready. There they are!
Let's just talk about this,
hands
right?
up!
I'm done here.
You wanna die?
Okay!
Stop moving! Enough is enough! I'm taking you-
I'm not dealing with this. I'm not paying for bounty anymore. It was an accident. There goes all the money I just made from the fucking perfect lab, though. Robbing stuff would just be easier. I want good bounty, not bounty owner. I want good owner, but he just keeps making me do stuff to decrease.
Worker in camp.
Someone's got to do it.
Well, don't let me disturb you.
Bye, Arthur.
Good morning, Arthur.
Come up here. Do I even wonder why he's up there? Underway. That would be why I'm dying so fast.
You get the deciding vote.
About what? We take an insult and scurry off like cockroaches? Or deal with business the right way?
We don't need to take revenge. We hardly know the guy.
This ain't about revenge, Hosea. Angelo Bronte don't mean shit to me. This is about the fact we are planning to rob a bank in his town. A bank that he no doubt protects. A town where his men are gunning for us. Before we do that, we need to put him out of commission.
I disagree. There's always an easier way.
There ain't no easier way. Now, I know his type. He is a vindictive little power broker who rules by fear. Now, we pull that stunt in his cesspit of a town, we're doomed. You want to leave this place? Leave this country? We need that money.
Just don't feel good, Dutch.
This is it. This is the last job that we are ever going to pull. Before the year is out, we are going to be harvesting mangoes in Tahiti. Farmers. But we need seed capital, and we need to leave. You know it. I know it.
Forgive me if I can't think too much about the mango harvest.
This is it. Trust me. Arthur.
If it's business, well, business is business.
Angelo Bronte stands between us and our future.
You'll damn us all.
Arthur, come on.
You better be right about this one.
I am.
I've heard that before, and usually I've been right. If you say so. Quit doubting, Arthur. It does no favors. Come on. We need to go see a man about a boat.
A boat?
We're headed to a settlement called Le Gras. I met a boatman there called Thomas who knows these waters like the back of his hand.
Why do we need a boat?
So we can attack Bronte's mansion from the swamp. Catch him off guard. He knows we survived the trolley station, so he'll be expecting some kind of reprisal.
All right. Okay, makes sense.
See? I do still possess some capacity for rational thought, Arthur. Okay, follow me.
I know I look glasses.
Yep. Thank you.
For what?
For taking my side back there.
It ain't about sides.
Feels like Hosea's lost his spine.
This move on Bronte, is it for the bank job or revenge for what happened at the trolley station?
Both. Neither. What does it matter? We need to hit that bank and Bronte. And just about everything else in Saint-Denis in his back pocket. That horse got your number, Arthur. Can we just get this done?
Anyway, you were saying,
he also set us up, and lest we forget, took young Jack.
I understand. We just got a lot of pots on the boil, given all the folks who's out gunning for us.
You all seem to have forgotten how money is made and what it takes to support 20 people, let alone what it takes to give 20 people a new life overseas.
Oh my god. Thanks, Dutch, so much for helping a guy who started to shoot at me. Fucking idiot!
I understand. We just got a lot of pots on the boil, given all the folks who's out gunning for us.
You all seem to have forgotten how money is made, and what it takes to support 20 people. Let alone what it takes to give 20 people a new life overseas.
With all due respect, Dutch, is this Tahiti plan really gonna work out?
You tell me, Arthur. Is it? Have some goddamn faith. I am bending over backwards to make a future for us.
I know, but...
But, when did you become so small-minded? If you'd rather we break up the family, go our separate ways, just tell me.
Of course not.
This isn't a prison camp. I am not forcing anybody to stay. So either we're in this together, working together to get out together, or we're not. There simply isn't a reality in which we do nothing and get everything.
I know. You're right. Just feels like we're on borrowed time again. I mean, the O'Driscolls found us.
Anyway, here we are. Let me do the talking.
Whoa. 500 weapons, man.
Thomas. It is good to see you, my friend.
Hello, Mr. Dutch.
Thomas, have you met Arthur? Arthur, Thomas is quite the boatman. He's gonna help us get close to our prey. The other night we had quite the adventure fishing for catfish. Now, my friend, can I call in that favor?
What do you need?
You know Angelo Bronte. Well, exactly. We need to make a social call. We were hoping you could row us in quietly one evening around the back of his house.
If anyone can, I can.
We'll pay you for your trouble.
If you're bringing him trouble, it won't be no trouble for me.
Good.
My business partner, Jules, he's out on the skiff. I need to check with him. Plus, I need to check the traps. Would you come with me?
Of course. Arthur?
Why not?
Shouldn't take too long if we can find him.
Eli, mind you, there's a lot of gators. Uncommon number. Big ones.
Great.
Come now, Arthur. It'd take more than a prehistoric reptile to scare you, surely.
I just want to see you meet your match when it comes to an aging predator with a big mouth, Dutch.
Arthur here is something of a comedian, Thomas. More of a jester than a gunslinger.
Well, if you say so, Mr. Dutch. This way. Come on, this way. Follow me here. And stay on the higher ground.
You call this ground? It feels like water to me.
Down here, we can't be too picky there, Mr. Arthur. Got a couple of crayfish traps up ahead.
This is just water at this point.
Mr. Dutch, you keep a lookout for company. Mr. Arthur. Check the traps with me.
This one's empty.
All right. I got a few more set over this way. Come on.
I don't want to know what just touched my leg.
Mr. Dutch, you show you the right fellas to be going after Angelo Brunson?
Oh, he's much more the kind of reptile I can handle.
Now stay close. Make sure you follow my line.
Oh, I fully intend to, Thomas.
You too, Mr. Arthur.
You can see why evening swamp wading hasn't caught on as a pastime, can't you?
I love it out here. Peaceful. Nobody bothering you now. Except for the night folk sometimes.
The night folk?
Yep, some strange people around these parts. Wilder than the animals they are.
Well, this just gets better and better.
At this point, we should just be swimming.
Whoa. Stop where you are. It's a gator.
Well.
Just stay as still as you can.
Oh.
Keep moving. I got another trap by that small island up here. I don't know what's taking Jules so long with that boat.
I think we are all equally keen to find him.
Why is down there?
A hand
Mr. Arthur. This trap is stuck in the mud. It happens.
Guess something didn't want to be caught.
My gosh. So it's true.
What is?
There's been talk of a big old bull, but people talk a lot of nonsense. I guess this was... No, but only something huge could do this.
Fantastic. Let's hope it bites you first, Dutch.
Should we just keep moving? I don't really want to hang around here much longer.
All right. I suppose this can wait. Let's go. Hold up.
That's a lot of gators.
My God, there's no shortage of them.
Good eating.
Us or them?
Exactly. Come on.
I'll take that as a both.
We really should have run into Jules by now. I reckon we should split up so we can search both sides.
Are you kidding?
Arthur, since you appear so at home here, you take the right. We'll go left.
What? Just keep your eyes open.
Fuck.
Yeah, cool.
Someone there?
Must be Jules. Where is the boat?
Over there. I ran.
Okay. And where did this monster swim off to?
I think that way. Good luck shooting that thing. You'll need a cannon.
I got the skiff. It's over here. Stuck. Got it loose. Jump.
Good man.
All right, let's get back to the dock.
Yes, please, let's go.
Thank God.
Wish I put something out here.
So, who are these fellas, Thomas?
Two new friends of mine. I'll explain later.
Jules, we are very happy to have finally made your acquaintance.
I thought I was gonna be out here all night.
What you doing hiding up in the tree, boy?
This gator was huge, Thomas. Twice as big as I ever seen. Twice as angry, too.
Well, boy, I think we hit a tree stump.
Hey, I thought we cleared. You're gonna need to jump in and pull us free.
Me?
Yeah, just do it. Won't take you a minute. Boy, go on.
This is a bad idea.
You'll see any giant monster long before it gets anywhere near you. Got a couple of crack gunslingers here with the guns loaded. You'll be fine.
You didn't see the thing.
Yeah, neither did you. It's just a myth, Jules. Now pull.
Holy shit, that thing is huge. Holy shit.
Too good there.
Here, take this. Try to stop bleeding.
You're gonna be okay, son. You're gonna be okay. Just thank your old Uncle Dutch.
I heard that.
Holy shit, that thing was huge.
There's still a lot of blood. You need to put pressure on it.
What do you think I'm doing?
I've stopped the bleed.
I full send kid like.
If he don't get a fever, we can bring down a fever.
A fever is the least of our worries. Look who's back.
God damn it.
Put every bullet you got in here.
Back now.
You're gonna be okay, kid. Sorry, Jules. Guess all them stories was true. Big and bad. That's unusual. Normally the little ones angry. Big ones is lazy.
Well, I guess he never outgrew his anger. Kinda reminds me of you, Arthur.
You know, I don't think I've ever seen you squeal before, Dutch.
I weren't the one squealing.
Yeah, well, you weren't in the water with him. And this poor boy was nearly dinner. Can we get some help? Jules has been bitten.
Oh, my God.
There's a monster out here. He's been bitten, but he's alive. Just keep him warm. Feed him garlic for the infection. Thank you. Both of you.
Now I'm at your service anytime
you
need.
Thank you, Thomas. Where can we find you?
You just meet me back here.
Very good.
Can one of you help me put the boat back out?
Sure. I'm gonna head back to camp and placate the irritable Miss O'Shea, who's causing more trouble. I'll collect the boys. Meet you back here, Arthur.
Mr. Arthur? Old Bronte. Bad man.
I know.
Killed some good folks. Hurt a lot of people.
Well, he definitely lacks a certain charm. I'll see you soon.
You be safe. You got monsters out here.
Well.
Dude, that thing is like... Like, it could, like, one... It's, like, bigger than my horse. That's me. That's neat. I love how I'm healing alligators. Okay, so that thing was terrifying. Imagine seeing that just come right at you. Safe to say that I would never go near water again. But anyways guys, I'll see you in the next Red Dead video. Bye.